before we will see the concept of what is meant by electric dipole and what will be the some important problems based on the electric dipole. Now let's see the another important concept, that will be the energy density in the electrostatic fields. Okay, here my concept will be the energy density. The main thing behind this energy density be the, we have to be assembled some charges, we have to be that assembled charges, we have to be considered some volume. From that charge to the that volume, we have to be considered some point, that be the P. What will happen? Okay, here in this case, if you want to assemble those type of charges, you must have to be first considered. Work must have to be done. Whenever you have to be done some work, then only the assembling of charges will be happening, right? And similarly, if you want to consider this be my infinite, this be my some infinite point, okay? And this be, I will be considered, this be my some volume, okay? And here, this be my point P1. Initially, if I want to move from infinite to point P, charge Q1, I don't have to be done any work. Why? Because initially it will be in the empty space. For that reason, from infinite to, I just want to put my charge in the, just in this P1, okay, that will be represented this Q1, okay. And similarly, from infinite to, I just want to put my charge Q2 in the my point, that be the P2. What will happen? So here, this be my point P2. Here my charge will become the Q2. And similarly, if I want to put my charge Q3 in point P3. Okay, this be my charge Q3. And here my target be the how much work I have to be done for this total three charges. One charge be the Q1, and another charge be the Q2, and last charge that be the Q3. For example, if you consider, I will be telling you this be my WE work done. Okay. That be the how many total work tons have to be done? Three work tons, right? W1 plus W2 plus W3. Here I already told you a couple of minutes ago. Initially, if you want to do the some work done from plus infinite to that point P1, initially that will be the zero, right? That means that be the empty, you don't need to done any work. So here this will become the zero plus, and what will happen to the W2? Work done, work done, W is equal to Q into V. So here this 2 represents my second charge. So this be my Q2 into V2, and this charge Q2 into V has to be dependent on the first charge. That will become the V21. Okay. And similarly, and what will be my W3? WV3 be the Q3, and what will be my potential? That be the V. That potential has to be dependent on the V3 1 plus V3 2. It depends upon the 3 and 1 and as well as the 3 and 2. Okay, this be my WE. This be the work done for this diagram. And similarly, if I just want to interchange my positions, what will happen if I just want to do the interchange my positions? Interchange the positions. Interchange the positions. Here you can see, I will be consider this be my point 1. W E that B equal to W3 plus W2 plus W1. I will just interchange the positions of work done. So whenever I will be interchange the positions also, now my first position will be the W3. If you want to put from infinite to that point P, okay, initially that be the empty, right? Empty space. That's why my W3 will become the 0 and as well as N. What will be my work done for the W2? Work done that will be equal to V into Q. So this will become the V2 and here this be the Q2. So here for this Q2, so this be the Q2, Q2 into and what will be the V2. So here this will become the V2. In the previous case that will be dependent, 2 will be dependent on 1, right? Now we have to be interchange the position. Now this, it will be depend on the 1, right? It will be depend on, sorry, 1 will be the 0, right? No charge be present. Why? Because that will be the empty. So it will be depend on the 3. And similarly, if you want to write for the work done for the W1, this will become the Q1 into, so this be the V1, 2 plus V 1 3. Okay, this be my equation 2. For example, if I will be add up the equation 1 plus equation 2, what will happen? Add equation 1 plus equation 2, this will become the double GE plus double GE, that will become the 2 double GE, that will be equal to, so here you can see this will be the Q2 V21 plus Q3 V31 plus Q3 V32 plus Q2 V23 plus this be the Q1 V12 plus Q1 V13 plus Q1 V13. Okay, now let's see the put the 1, 2 and 3 terms here. If you want to put the 1 terms, that will become the Q1 here, this will become the V12 plus V13. And similarly, if you want to put the 2, Q2 V21 plus V23 plus, similarly if you want to put your charge Q3 into V31 plus V32. Okay, so this will become the 2 double GE. So for example, if you want to just negate this voltage is potential difference V12, V123 like that. Okay, what will happen? This will become the Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. So what will happen to the WE? That be equal to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 divided by 2. Okay, so you can't neglect that. What will happen? So this will become the, if you want to consider Q1 V1 plus Q2 V2 plus Q3 V3. So this will become the Q1 V1 plus Q2 V2 plus Q3 V3 divided by 3. And how you can write this, divided by 2. So WE, how you can write this? If you want to put 1 by 2 common. So this will become the, here you can see Q1 V1 plus Q2 V2 plus Q3 V3. So here I will be consider this total term, that be the V1, okay, this V2 plus V21 plus V23, that will be the total term that I will be considered, that be my V2, And similarly, V31 plus V32, I will be considered this be my V3. Okay, so that's why I will be write Q1 into V1 plus Q2 into V2 plus Q3 into V3. If I want to revoke my V1, what will happen? If I want to just what will happen inside the V1? That will be the inside V12 plus V13. What will happen the inside? If you want to see the V2, that will be the V21 plus V23. Similarly, for V3, that will be the V31 plus V32. Right? So here you can see it will be from 1, 2, 3 up to the how much it will be go? It will be go up to the n values, right? Similarly, I will be put by means of summation. This will become the summation of k is equal to 1. It will be started with the 1. It will be go up to the n values. So k is the summation of k is equal to 1 to n. So this will become the qk vk. This will be the important conclusion whenever we have to be done the work done. W is equal to 1 by 2, summation of k is equal to 1 to n, qk vk. And similarly, if you want to find out for the what will happen to the line charge, surface charge and the volume charge density, I will be tell you this be the, I will be considered here that be the some volume, right? Here if you can see, or if you can see the for work done for the surface, that be the 1 by 2 into integration of L rho L into V into dl, this be for line. Okay, for surface that be equal to 1 by 2 integration of S rho S into V into ds, this be for surface. And similarly, WE that be equal to 1 by 2 integration of V rho V into dv, so this be for volume. This be for volume. Okay, I will be just try to concentrate on the volume. What will happen from the Maxwell's first equation? What will be the formula for the Maxwell's first equation? From Maxwell's first equation, what will happen to the del dot d that will be equal to rho v, del dot d that will be equal to rho v. Okay, first, second, this be my, I will be considered, for example, this be my third equation, this be my fourth. Put equation 4 in equation 3. What will happen? So WE that be equal to 1 by 2 integration of V, in place of del rho V, you have to be put your del dot D. Del dot D into V into dV. Okay? Here you can see, here this be the notation, right? This be the one of the formulas I will be telling you in the important point section, right? So if you want to consider the A dot B dot C, how you can write in terms of the vectors? So this will become the 1 by 2 integration of V. So del dv into dv minus 1 by 2 integration of V d del V into dv, right? And here so this will become the 1 by 2 integration of V del dv into V into dv minus 1 by 2 integration of V d into del V into dv. So for example, for this right hand side, if I want to apply the Stokes theorem, what will happen? The closed surface that will be equal to the volume, right? Here if you want to apply the Stokes theorem, so this will become the surface. So here this will become the E bar dot. So in place of E, you have the V, right? V dot d s. V dot ds minus 1 by 2 integration of V d of del V into dv. So here this will become the So this becomes the VD. VD dot DS minus 1 by 2 integration of VD del V into DU. For example, if I will be considered the surface be the more larger, okay, if I will be considered the surface be the more larger, what you have to say? We have to be neglect this. We have to be neglect this. Why? Because larger surface. If I will be consider larger surface. If I consider larger surface, means you just have to neglect that surface. What will be our remaining terms? That be the minus 1 by 2 integration of V d del V into dV. Okay. So this be our work done WGG. You already know what will be the electric potential formula. That be the E is equal to minus del V. Okay. And similarly, what will happen to the D? D is equal to epsilon naught into E. D is equal to epsilon naught into E. Substitute this E is equal to minus del V and D is equal to epsilon naught E in this formula. What will happen? This will become the minus 1 by 2 integration of V in place of D. That be the epsilon naught E in place of del V. That be the minus E into dV. So here this will become the minus into minus, this will become the plus 1 by 2 integration of E epsilon naught E square into dV. This be our work done. This be our work done. This be the so simple and as well as the important. And here in this case, what the things you have to be remember means that be the this formula. Okay. A, B, C. If I will be give. How you can write? So this be the example, this be the A, B, and this be the C. How you can write? A, del dot D into V, right? This be the V, yes. Okay, how you can write? A, B, C minus B, C, B, A, C. Okay. In that way, you can have to remember. Next, we have to apply only right hand side by the Stokes theorem. Stokes theorem means you just have to above closed surface that will be equal to the volume. So, why will be considered that volume or that surface means whenever you have to be taken the point surface, if you want to consider your D, that be the 1 divided by r, right? And if you want to consider in the dipole also, it will become the 1 divided by r cube. That means it will radius will go on increasing, right? Our distance that will be go on increasing. So that's why I will be considered my surface be the larger surface. That means you just have to be neglected that surface, and we have to be mainly concentrated on the volume, and you have to be concentrated on the volume of this term. For this term, last we have to be applied our electrical potential and as well as in your electric flux density formula. There you have to be getting your work done. That be equal to 1 by 2, that be the epsilon naught E square into dV. Okay, this was the simple question based on the energy density. In the next class, we will try to see what will be the method of images and the important questions based on the method of images. Okay, thank you.